Hi, I'm Keith with Danfoss Food Retail Controls, and today's video will be on troubleshooting temperature sensors in a real-time environment. In this video, we're going to do some troubleshooting of a temp sensor. So this is going to be a basic layout where we will have the temp sensor that is in some ice water. That'll get us very close to a medium temp application. We'll have our wire that is going to be running from the case back to the control. And then here we have our I/O boards, and lastly we have our system manager. So as a package, we can very easily troubleshoot to find out the status of our sensor. So as you can see on the chart, we work in a range from minus 58, which is 800 ohms, up to 95 degrees, which is 1136 ohms. The sensor is a PT1000, so 1000 ohms is equal to 32 degrees. And if you wanted to reference a low temp application of close to minus 10, you would be about 910 ohms. So now we're going to look at the different scenarios for a temp sensor. As we have it right now in normal operating conditions, we can see on the display 33.4 degrees. But what is it going to show us if we have a short? Well, I'll take these two leads and I'll hold them together. And we notice it goes to a minus 148. So now we have that condition. The other one, other than the normal, will be an open. I remove one of the leads. We're going to see that it is going to 392. So our outside extremes plus our normal condition are typically what we need to be dealing with. The other thing that we can always do is take our leads to our meter, and if we go on either one of the, or across the two leads, we're going to see our ohm reading being 1,000 ohms. That's exactly what we're expecting it to be, which is an indication that we are right on money when it's a medium temp case and we are in a 32 degree environment. So now we're going to start troubleshooting to find out why we have a short. So we've come into the store. We see that we have a minus 148 on the display. That's telling us that somewhere from the system manager down to that case, we have a shorted condition. The best way to troubleshoot is to isolate your problem and or possibly divide this troubleshooting into two pieces. Well, if we are in the compress room working, we have the system manager, we have the I/O all local to us, it is very simple to go up to my I/O, to disconnect the lead going down to my case sensor, and notice that it went to 392, which means we have an open. So from my I/O board, I can tell a short and an open. That means that the operation of my I/O and my system manager are correct, they're good. That means also that the problem has to exist either in the wiring or in the sensor itself. We're now down on the floor and we're going to further evaluate or troubleshoot this problem. So we're not going to go to where the sensor is inside the case. We're going to go to where the wires are connected to the cable returning to the I/O or back up to the motor room. I will go down here and I will remove at least one of the two wires, and I'm going to take my meter and I'm going to put it across, and I'm looking for it to show me somewhere very close to 1,000 ohms, because I know from that chart that 1,000 ohms has me very close to 32 degrees. There's an excellent indicator that the sensor itself is good. We will work with the assumption, at least right at this moment, that the cable's the problem. How could I best evaluate that? I will take the two cable leads, and I will put my meter on volts DC, and I'm going to read back and see what I have coming from my I/O. Notice I have a short. So now my troubleshooting was very simplified, that I verified all the I/O was correct, I verified the sensor was correct, and I also verified that the cable is shorted. So to recap on our troubleshooting, we first validated that where the problem was located, so we went back to the system manager and to the I/O, we did a short and open, and we validated or verified that the problem was not there. We went down to the sensor, we put our meter on, ohm meter, we verified that the ohm reading was correct, and then we read back through the cable and we found out it was shorted. The cable has now been replaced. Everything has been rewired back to the norm. And if I look on the display, I'm reading 33 degrees. So everything is back to good. For more information on this topic, see the description below. And for more videos like this, visit our YouTube channel, Danfoss Cool US, and thank you for watching.